Hello, welcome to Ekidel. My name is Justice Umoka. I am your instructor. Today, I'll be showing you how to arrange your structural detailing for a presentation or for printing. So after you're done with your design, the next thing is to produce your structural detailing. The kind of software you use to design your structure can be Protastructure or Rivet Structure or StatPro or any other design software like ETAP. But if you're using Protastructure, which I normally use on my design, and also for the video tutorial, which I already show you guys. Now, after you're done with your structural design in Protastructure software, the next thing you have to do is to go and produce your detailed drawings using your Prota detail. And after that, you now export that to AutoCAD. As you can see right now, I am using AutoCAD 2023 and it is a registered AutoCAD company here. Now, as you can see also, this is a well-arranged structural drawing presentation, as you can see it here. So today I'll be showing you how to arrange your structural drawing one after the other for a good presentation, which will now be used for construction. Okay, now before I show you this company logo, I have already taken a license or a copyright or license to use this company logo for this tutorial, and the name of this company is Osas Engineering Limited. So the first thing that you have to do is to put your company logo or the templates of the structural drawing just as it is. If you don't have a company logo, you can just put a structural drawing page just like this, and then take off the logo. If you don't have a logo, as you can see it here, leave it this way. But I would say that if you have a logo, you just leave the logo. So the first thing that you must arrange first, or the first thing on the line when you are flipping your structural drawing, the first thing you will see is to see this structural drawing note, which tells them that what they are about to read is the structural drawing, or what they are about to view is structural drawing. Okay, now after this note right now, the next thing you see right now is your general construction instruction. Is to show your general construction instruction. I'll put this template down below. So it's to show your general construction notes right here, which consists of all the instructions. You can see it here that all structural elements, all structural drawings and sketches must be read. You can see it here. So you have to put all the notes, all the instructions that you want. Like right now, you can see that all dimensions are in millimeter unless otherwise stated. Okay, you can also see the reinforcement here, which tells you your reinforcement grade, your steel grade, which you used. Okay, you can also see the kind of abbreviations that you use. So you also explain it here. And also, you can also see the concrete where you put your concrete cover for foundation, for column, and for beams and other concrete elements, and also the grade. You can see the grade here. Now, if you go to the cover, you can see the cover right here. You can see that minimum, this is for grade and this is for cover. You can see that the minimum cover is this. So the next thing you want to have is these structural notes, which also consist of your soil bearing capacity. You can see this place here, soil preparation. It also consists your soil bearing capacity and all that. So you have this is where all the informations from the design, which you use from the design, will be. So after this cover image, the next thing that you see right now is the general construction notes, which you just see here right now, which can also put your logo if you don't want to leave it. Okay, so after these two right now, the next thing you're going to see is your foundation layout. Now, even if it is a rough foundation, a pipe foundation, a part foundation, any kind of foundation, the first thing you're going to see is your foundation, because that is where they're going to start construction, is from foundation. So the first thing you're going to put is foundation layout, as you can see it here. This is a part foundation layout, as you can see them right here. This is part foundation layout. You can see this base type 11, base type 9. So this is a part foundation layout. You can see also here where you also put your project, the name of the project. You can see this is for proposed residential development for Mr. blah 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 and that. Now also you have to put also the client's name. I can see it right here. Then also you have also title this drawing. This title is called part foundation layout. I can see it right now. Okay, you also have to give a note. You can give a note what is contained there. That all you can see right now, I give a note that all dimensions are in millimeter except otherwise stated. Then that next thing comes right here is your logo and all that. And I'm just trying to explain this template right here, this template. Then you have to also put your name, the name of the designer. I can see there, Justice Umoka. I am Engineer Justice Umoka, and my checker is Engineer Samuel Ogidi. And I also drew, I did the design, and I also did the drafting. I did this design the year November 2020, as you can see it right now. And then you have to also number the sheets. So these two pages, they are not numbered. You don't number these two pages. This is just an this is just a cover page, and this is the structural notes which gives all the instruction contained in this detail. So the first page, now the sheet one or the page one, should be this foundation layout. Foundation layout must be your page one. Now after foundation layout, right now I can see that what we have here is a pad footing. So we have a pad footing right here. So you have to now go and detail this pad footing. So this pad footing now becomes the page two. So if we look at it right now, we have different kind of pad footing here. So that takes me now to page two, which is sheet two right here, using the same template. Can you see it right here? Now page two right now tells me all the informations. Page two now tells me all the informations that are inside this foundation layer, which is this page one. So page two will tell you the informations that is in page one, and page one now will have to refer you that if you want to see this information, go to page two. So right, you can see right now this is a part foundation layout, and right now on this place on page two, this is a part foundation detail. So you can see how it is being arranged from foundation layout to the foundation detail. So this is also a foundation detail, and this is also it. It was not able to enter this place, so I have to create another sheet to paste this one. That one, you can see it here. So this is another foundation layout, which is the page three right now, because they are both the same. Now also, after the foundation layout right now, since we have already I have already shown the person reading this drawing, I have shown him that this foundation layout, this foundation part base have been detailed in page two. Now, the next thing I have right now is my column. So you can see that this column also, they are being numbered. Column two, you can see this is column one. C1 means column one. So I have already numbered, I have already detailed this base from here in page two. Now, I have to now go and show my reader or the person viewing this drawing that this column is also detailed in the next page after this. So which comes to now page three, as you can see it here. So page four right now consists of column details. You can see my column details right here. You can see the lapping, everything here is in place, and also the connection between the foundation and the column, here. So you can see that I detailed also the column, which is on this place, and the column was not able to enter all the sheets, or all the column was not able to enter on this template, so I transferred them to this one also. So this is page five. Now once I am done with, now on this foundation right now, what the main element found here is this part base and this column. So I have detail them here on sheet two, sheet three, and sheet four, and sheet five. So now I am done with my foundation layout. The next thing, this is called, this three right now is called the substructure. So I have done with my substructure detailing. Now we are about to enter the superstructure. So the superstructure right now starts from the first floor beam layout. So the first floor beam and column layout, or you just say first floor beam layout, but I will say you can say any of them. So but the main thing is to show you the first floor layout. So after the substructure, after the columns, the next thing that comes is the first floor layout. The first floor layout consists of the beams and the slab. You can see that right now. But on this case right now, this consists of the beam and the slab, and also numbers of columns also. But already we have already detailed all the columns right here in page five and page four and page five. Now, right now, what on this layout right now, what we have not detailed right here is the slab and the beam. So right now, this takes me to the next page, which is page This page six, layout is page six, and the next page right now is page seven. As you can see, the page seven right now tells you your bin detail. You can see the FB1, which is now detailed. Now you can see the FB1 here. You can see the floor bin one. This F means floor, floor bin one. Let me just shift this place so that it will not look as if we are together. This is for column. So this is floor bin one. So right now, if my reader sees this right now, they'll say, ah, what does this mean? This means floor bin one, okay? So where can I find the detail? Immediately he flips the next page, what he's gonna see is the detail of the beam. So that transmits, that makes the reader to, that makes this drawing to look very interesting for the reader, because he's not taking his time to find where this beam detail is. So that's why I said I want to show you how to arrange it perfectly step by step, so that you don't make mistake in arranging your structural detail drawing before printing. Okay, so you can now see that this is now the bin details. You can see also the sections just here. You can see the perfect sections here right now. Okay, so right now, then next thing right now to do right now is to paste all the beams. If the beams cannot enter one sheet, you now transfer it to the next template again, to the next sheet. So this is sheet 7 and this is sheet 8. So this first floor beams from this first floor layout contains sheet 7, sheet 8, and sheet 9. Now, at this sheet 9, we now detailed all the, this is where the end of the bin detail stops. Now, the next thing we have here right now is our slab, showing our slab. Now, your reader will be asking himself, okay, now that I've seen the bins, where can I find the slab? Now, immediately he flips after the last beam detail. Next thing he's gonna see is the slab. As you can see, the slab right here, showing also the sections, as you can see them right here. So right now, the slab comes immediately after the first floor beam details. Now, this slab detailing comes just after the first floor beam details, immediately it comes. So this slab detail right now is sheet 10. As you can see it right now. So right now, once we finish this slab, the next thing right now that comes up is the second floor roof layout. But on this case, it is the roof bin layout, because this is just a one-story building. So since I am done with my first floor bin layout, next thing I'm going for is for the roof layout. So that is why I say roof layout. But if you have up to 10 stories, after the first floor slab, the next thing you're gonna have is the second floor beam layout, and then you also continue with your beam details for that layout. After that, again, you do the third floor beam layout. I don't know if you understand. So right now, the next thing I have right now is the roof beam details, because this is just a one-story building, and since I have passed my since I've passed my first floor, the next thing I'm gonna approach, is the beam. So it's the roof beam. So that is, once you pass your slab, the next thing you're gonna start construction is the roof beam. So that is why you're seeing this roof beam layout right here. So on this roof beam layout right now, you also have your, you can see that this label has not changed, called this is roof beam. But on this place, we have our first floor layout, just called F1, which means floor beam. Okay, so right now you can see also going to this place right now. You can see this right now. This is now a roof beam. Now, the reader right now is okay. On this roof place right now, this roof was not designed as a roof slab. So there is no slab on this roof right now. So he's not intending to see graph. So he knows, okay, where can I find this roof beam details? Immediately he flips the next page to F, he's gonna see the roof beam details. As you can see it here, this is roof beam detail 1. So if you also go at the layout right now, this is the layout, he also see roof beam detail. So immediately the man flips, or your reader or your viewer flips the next page, which is page 2F, he sees the roof beam detail, as you can see it right here. Now, if the doom bit detail cannot be able to enter one sheet, because you can see that the scale here is bigger, just to show the reader, just to make just to make this drawing or the detail visible. So right now, you also transfer it to the next page and also continue your numbering to the next stage. So at this place, right now, this ends the roof beam detail. This is roof beam 24. This is where it ends. And if you also check at this model here, you can see that this is roof beam 24. This is where it ends. This is 23 and this 24. So this is the end of the roof beam on the layout. So you also detail this beam right here. And so this is where it ends. And this is sheet 24. Sorry, this is sheet 14, sorry. Now, immediately after this right now, what comes next right now? If you see on this model, there is a void here. This void is a staircase void. You can see that this symbol simply means a void. So this void is a staircase void. So when the reader saw this, he might be asking himself, where can I find this staircase? Well, he didn't just call you back or say that this is nonsense. He will just continue to be reading. And on the last page right now, you now have your staircase. You can see there. Staircase is always preferable to be at the last page of your structural drawing. So it's only meant to be at the last stage, you can see. So this is now the staircase, you can see right now. This is the staircase, perfectly detailed, you can see that. And the staircase is the last sheet, which is sheet 15. So you can now see how this is how to arrange your structural drawing perfectly. And if you want to print right now, it's very easy to print. You just click on this place right now and begin to print. Just click OK and then begin to print. Just choose a printer. Just come here and choose a printer right away. And then you click on, if you want to print from model view right now, just right click on this right now, and then click at this point right now, and then just say preview right now, you will see your, you can see that right now. I am going to print on black and white. So you can see right here, you just right click on that and say plot, and then click on plot, and that's all. It will now go to printer. And if I click on the escape right now, and then if I now click again to print the next one again right now, if I click on this right now on this point and then click on this point right now, and then if I now go up just now and then preview, first you have to refresh and preview to see if everything is okay. I can see that everything is okay. If I now right click and now say plot, it goes right now to the printer to print. Okay, so I get again right now, if I just click on this window to select my window. If I now go again to click on this to print this one right now and click on this point, I now print on I now print for the sheet one. Let me just go here to see this and then print on preview. And then once I preview it and everything is okay, I will just right click and say plots, and that goes for printing immediately. Okay, so right now again we go and click on this point, and then so that's how you do till let me do the slab area. So if I click on this place to print it for the slab, and then we go now we are going to print sheet 10. Okay, so we go now and print and just a preview. And then once it is okay, you can see the slab detailing very perfect. Once it is okay, you can see very perfect, having the top bar and bottom bar. So you can now right click and say plot immediately, and then that goes for printing immediately. Okay, so again, if you want to print the staircase to which is the last point, so that's how you do till you print the final one, and then you now carry it and then bind it together, staple it together and bind it, and then go and submit to your client or to your boss. So this is how to perfectly arrange your structural detail drawing. You can see that right now. You can see that very neat. You can see that. You can see very perfectly. So this is how to arrange. This is how to arrange your structural detail drawing one after the other. I'm gonna drop these templates on this drop down right now on the description that you can use it to also learn, or I'll just drop a PDF copy of these so that you also know how to arrange it one after the other. So thank you for this one, and then thank you for being with me to the end of this tutorial, and then thank you.